Hey guys, you're in the studio once again with Luke from GuitarIQ.com. I've been getting some great feedback and questions across the videos, and today I've just got a really quick and simple Logic Pro 10 tip that I think is going to help some people out. When we sit down to record something, there's a lot of things going on behind the scenes between what we're playing and what we're getting sent back to us through our studio monitors or headphones. Despite all of the benefits of digital audio, one of the things that unfortunately we still have to deal with is this issue of latency, or in other words, the small timing delays that occur between what we play and what we hear. For guitar players, when we plug into an amp simulator, this can be especially frustrating if we're mainly used to the feel and response we get from a real amplifier. Fortunately, Logic Pro 10 does give us a few different options for dealing with latency, and in this video I'm just going to highlight a couple of key things to keep in mind. So the first thing we really want to look at are our I/O buffer settings. We can access these if we come up to Logic Pro 10, down to Preferences, and across to Audio. What we're really looking at here is this drop-down menu. Now, the general idea is the lower the setting, the less latency we're going to experience. We can get confirmation of that if we look at the resulting latency. If I increase the buffer size, you'll see that increases. So why don't we just always leave this set to the lowest possible setting? Well, because we really have to work within the parameters that our individual system is going to allow. Logically, the more our computer is working to reduce latency, the more processing power it's going to need to access. If our system can't keep up, we're going to get a lot of issues on playback, from clicks and pops in our audio to our session completely crashing mid-song, which isn't really conducive to getting the perfect take. So if we're finding that our system is limiting us from getting this buffer size as low as we'd like, is there anything that we can do about it? Does Logic give us any other options? Well, the good news is, yes, it does. If I come over to the General tab and down to the Plugin Latency section, what we want to focus in on is this checkbox for Low Latency Mode. What this will do is optimize our track to work within the threshold that's selected here. Logic will essentially start dealing with things that are going to cause more latency than the limit that we've set this to. Now, depending on the plugins we're using in our session, while we're in this mode, it may start to affect how things sound, and the difference could potentially range from very subtle to fairly dramatic. So keep in mind, this is something you may want to engage when you're tracking, but definitely something you want left off when you're mixing. And lastly, to make things a bit easier, Logic have provided a quick and easy way to toggle in and out of this mode. If I come up here and right click, I can then select Customize Control Bar and Display. I can now check Low Latency Mode here, press OK, and now I have a control that I can access from right here within the main window. So if you weren't familiar with using Low Latency Mode, I think it's a really handy little feature that's going to help a lot of you guys out when you go to record your tracks. That's it for this video. If it's helped you out, then click on the like button or leave some feedback. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, be sure to head over to guitariq.com for more videos and content. All of the links for everything, including the other places you can check the channel out, are going to be in the description. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.